grace and mercy and peace from the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And yeah, tomorrow starts 2018. And we are beginning as a church, and churches all around the world, are beginning 2018 with the shedding of blood. Not only the shedding of blood itself, but the shedding of a baby's blood. And that's our gospel reading for today. In Luke 2, we read about Joseph and Mary bringing Jesus in the temple to do for him what the custom of the law required, circumcision, a mark in the flesh that God had instituted for his people some 2,000 years before Jesus, during the time of Abraham, to set them apart from everybody else as belonging to Yahweh, belonging to God. So at 8 days old, and then you're like seminary, it kind of depends on how you do time, but at 8 days old, here's the point. Jesus shed his blood for the first time in identification with us. Already at 8 days old, he's fulfilling the law on our behalf. That's why we just say what we said. That's why in verse 3 it says, his infant body now begins to cross the field. Those precious drops of blood that flow for death, the victim Jesus seals. That's why our song says, why our hymn says what it says. That's why we sang this hymn. So what's his life been like? He's a week old. What's been happening here? He's had the shock of being born. He's had the helplessness of a baby. And he's had the pain of a cut in the flesh. The creator of the universe, the King of Kings, and the Lord of Lords has to have his diaper changed. The first week of his earthly life has been exactly what any baby would have experienced, you, me, any of us. Here's the point, Jesus is one of us. He is our God who became man, the infinite who stepped into flesh and bone. He knew all the things that we experienced, hunger, thirst, mental, emotional, and physical pain. He knew them all. Because not only did he create us, he became one of us. That means he knows. Now, did y'all hear what I just said? Who knows? Okay? Who knows? He knows the pains of this past year. He knows the sadnesses, the heartaches, and the pain. He also knows the joys and the excitement of 2017. He was there with you on those nights when you couldn't sleep. Because he spent nights awake too all night long, pouring his heart out to his father, Abba. He was there during those days in the hospital when the doctors and nurses were absent and all he could do was just stare up at the ceiling and wonder if he'd been forgotten. He was forgotten. He was abandoned and left all alone by his friends and by his family. He heard the people laugh at you, gossip about you, slander you, think you're a fool. He's been on the receiving end of those words too, and those people will have to answer for every word they said. He is our God. He is a man well acquainted with our sorrows. That's what it says in Isaiah. The point is, he knows. He knows. Not only does he know, he feels. Never was there a child who experienced a crucifixion where the parents didn't feel the spikes in the wrists and ankles. His heart broke with your heart when you were left in that state by someone you thought you could trust. His laughter rang loud and echoed throughout the universe when your heart leaped in joy at a good thing. His joy broke over you in song time and time again, just as his eyes were wet with tears when yours were. We do not have a God who is so far removed from us that he has no idea what we're experiencing or what we go through. What we have is a God who is intimately familiar with every aspect of our lives. Number one, because he's God. But number two, because he lived them too. He experienced everything we experience, beginning at his own birth, beginning with what we're celebrating today. Mark in the flesh. Okay, all right. Very good. now? What does it mean for 2018? What's that mean for tomorrow? Here's the thing. I don't know what 2018 is going to bring for any of you. I don't know what it's going to bring for me. I don't know what 2018 is going to be. I don't know if 2018 is going to be your year or if it's going to be, what a year. I don't know if this time, next year, at the end of December 2018, if you're going to say, thank God for the year 2018 was, or if you're going to say, thank God 2018 is over. I don't know. What I do know is this. No matter what 2018 ushers in, God is already there. He is already intimately knowledgeable about what is going to happen, the good stuff and the not so good stuff. And he's already prepared a way for us through the highs and the lows. And no matter what happens, and here's where it gets hard for you and me, no matter what happens, good or bad, from our very limited human perspective, because we can only see this much, God sees all of this. So no matter what happens, God keeps his promises that in all things he works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. Even if we can't see it. Even if we can't see how. Even if in the lowest of lows we can't see how anything good is going to come out of this. Even when we think, this is so great, it can't get any better than this. Our God knows. He knows. He cares. He is there, and he will always remain with us, Emmanuel. That's what Christmas was all about. God with us. We saw it in the manger this past Christmas. We saw it in the reading today with Jesus shedding his blood for the first time for us. We'll see it as he experiences being despised and rejected by people, being spiked to a cross, and dying. And we'll see it on Easter Sunday when we celebrate his resurrection. And we'll remember it again when he pours out his Holy Spirit on us at Pentecost. Our God has come to us, Emmanuel. And he's never going to leave. But we can walk away from him. He gives us that option. Not going to force us. We can leave him. We can walk away. But he will never leave us. He is our Emmanuel. So let's go to him in prayer. Jesus, thank you for so identifying with us that you even became a person and experienced all the same things we do. Thank you that you know exactly what we experience and go through because you experienced and went through the same things too. Thank you for 2017. Throughout the world, our nation, and our individual lives are many times of great joy and sorrow, ups and downs. But the point is, you remained the one rock-steady constant in a world of shifting sand. Be with us as we enter into 2018. We don't know what the new year will hold, but we do know that you do. We trust you. We love you. We will base our lives in you, and we will take captive every thought to make it obedient to you as you have told us in your word to do. You are our God. Our God who knows us inside and out. Our God who knows us better than we know ourselves. Keep us this day, this night, every day after into the new year and beyond. It's in your name, Jesus.